Welcome, Richa, on our channel MYB. So, audience, let us listen to Richa herself speaking about her career and what she is doing passionately for so many years. Yes, Richa, please tell us.
Right. Thank you so much, Rajesh, for first of all hosting me on your channel MYB. I do appreciate you taking time from your busy schedule to conduct this interview. So about myself, my name is Richa, as you all already know. I hail from the small town called Ranchi. Well, Ranchi actually got famous only after MS Dhoni brought Ranchi to limelight. So belong to Ranchi, but came to Mumbai way back in 2002 with dreams in my eyes to make it big in the city of dreams, which is Mumbai. Started my career with aviation, flew with two of the biggest airlines that time, domestic airlines in India. Worked with them for about 3.5-4 years. Quit flying, got into training. Well, actually, training happened by chance, by fluke. I never thought I'd get into training. And once I did get into training, I realized it's my passion, it's my calling. Love training, very, very passionate about empowering and transforming lives. And when I did get into training, I got a lot of certifications to help improve my skills as a trainer. Worked with a couple of corporates for about 3-4 years. But then there was always this dissatisfaction in my heart that, you know, I want to do something of my own. I want to be my own boss, be my own, you know, take my own risks in life, etc. So I quit training, I mean, the corporate career after about a couple of years and started my own enterprise or my own training company, which is called as Envision Training. Way back in 2016. So October 2016, Envision was born, and it's like how you have a newborn baby, you nurture it, you take care of it, you love it. So in the same way I have done with Envision, I've given it my all, my hard work, my sweat, my blood, everything to make it a functional company and make it an empowering and transforming company.
So you're touching lives of many
people. So that is what... Yes. We have trained close to 4 lakhs people in these last 4 years of being into operation and touching the lives of people, touching, you know, making them better at, you know, their productivity, making them more efficient at their work. Like how corporates, you know, in the corporates, the main challenge is how do you keep an employee motivated? How do you make sure that the person is continuously engaged at work? So that is what we've been doing very, very closely with Envision. We've been trying to reach out to corporates and make sure that, you know, we are able to get the employees super motivated, super charged up and brimming with positivity when they come for work. So that's been what our priority has been at Envision, making sure that we are able to of course, have the business impact as well. In the end, the ROI has to be met, and that's what we've been doing at Envision. We make sure that it's a holistic 360-degree circle wherein we do a pre-training analysis, we conduct the training, we do a post-training engagement as well.
So what are your USPs so that people always contacting you and want to know more from yourself?
Sure. So, well, Envision's USP has been very clearly 3 very, very important, or rather, I would say 4 important USP of Envision. The first and foremost is that Envision believes in making our training sessions and workshops very, very engaging to the participants. So, we guarantee to our clients that your participants will be awake, engaged, and stimulated. That's a guarantee from our end. So awake, stimulated, and engaged is what we make sure that the clients, the participants are going to be in the session. They're not just going to be as passive observers. They're going to be active participants in the training session. So that's the first USP. The second USP of Envision is that we make sure that our sessions are experiential in nature. So learning happens through fun. Whatever point we want to bring across, we ensure that it's done in a fun manner because people learn, you know, love to learn through in fun ways. You know, we don't believe in having very detailed PowerPoints, presentations, and slides, etc. We ensure that is, you know, participants have fun while learning. So that's the second USP. Experiential learning is what Envision guarantees. The third USP is that we believe in the power of storytelling. So after a point of time, the participants may forget Richa, they may forget the trainers, they may forget the PowerPoint, the data, the statistics, the facts or theories that were spoken during the session. But what they don't forget are the stories. So in Vision, make sure that while we are conducting our training sessions and workshops, we ensure that we wove them around through stories. So whatever points you want to, whatever topics you want to say during the training, whatever be it time management or communication skills or presentation skills, whatever be the topic, we ensure that we give out the message very, very strongly through the power of storytelling. So that is the third USP, which brings me to the last USP of Envision, which is, it's all about the clients for us. So Envision definitely believes in this power of, making sure that we give our all to the clients. So for us, it's the clients who are always coming first for us. We ensure that we give them the best of service, and because of which we've been able to retain our clients and, ensure that they don't go anywhere else. They always come back to us. Any so those are the four USPs of Envision.
Any success stories you would like to share? Success stories about your Envision?
Absolutely. So there have been many success stories, but there is one story which stands out for Envision and for me particularly as a founder of Envision Training. So 2018, we had the Women's Day celebration on 8th of March, which is there every year. And 2018, the 8th of March, we conducted an open workshop for about 2,500 women, wherein we made them undergo some breakthrough activities like fire walk. We made them do glass walk, iron rod bending, brick breaking. Now, these are activities wherein women feel a little challenged, but the idea was to get them out of their comfort zone and get them into the challenging zone.